bright and early, right? You probably noticed we have a little bit more color in the sanctuary this morning. More than a third, too. They came here on Friday morning and to install windows. And I thought they were just doing a third, but apparently they had some big projects coming up, and they just wanted to get this one done. And so we have all of them. And I think they did a really good job. Our design committee, too, for picking out the symbols and the style and everything. So thank you to all of you on the design committee. I think they did a really good job. And now I have some children's message material for explaining all the symbols. So that works good, too. Not a whole lot of announcements today, to be honest. Just point out that midweek Bible class continues this Wednesday. We just finished up on Long Gospel. We'll be talking about some of the characters and people in the Bible and maybe the struggles they went through and how God used them to move forward his plan of salvation. So that's 6:30 on Wednesdays. Here, all my Vermilion stuff will be on Thursdays, so that shouldn't interfere with our day-to-day here. That's all I have, other than just good to see you all here. It's early morning. Any of you have any announcements? I heard the ATV trip was a great success. A lot of people went. A lot of people had fun. Only one person got soaked in wet, falling into a barn, so that's good. Right. What's that? You'll have to ask Jay for all the details. I don't know. any prayer requests this morning? Yes, Bill.
Prayer for my son-in-law is going in under surgery tomorrow morning.
Okay, yeah. We'll pray for Billy.
Yeah. I'm from the Wendy. She's got to go into the stress test.
Okay, what are you doing to your in-laws, Bill, that they have to have surgery? We'll pray for Billy and Wendy this morning, sir. All right, anything else? All right, well, then I invite you to rise and drink one another with Peace Lutheran Church.
Unto the Lord. And I do forgive the iniquity of my sin.
We take a moment for personal reflection. O Almighty God, merciful Father,
I, a poor miserable sinner, confess unto you all my sins and iniquities, with which I have ever offended you, and justly deserved your temporal and eternal punishment. But I am heartily sorry for them, and I sincerely repent of them, and I pray you of your boundless mercy, and for the sake of the holy, innocent, bitter sufferings and death of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, to be gracious and merciful to me, a poor sinful being.
Upon this, your confession, I, by virtue of my office as a called and ordained servant of the Word, announce the grace of God unto all of you. And in the stead and by the command of my Lord Jesus Christ, I therefore forgive you all your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
We continue with our introit, which is found in your bulletin. Blessed be the Lord.
For he has heard the voice of my pleas for mercy.
The Lord is my strength and my shield. In him my heart trusts and I am helped.
My heart exults, and with my song I give thanks to him.
The Lord is the strength of his people.
He is the saving refuge of his anointed.
O save your people and bless your heritage.
Be their shepherd and carry them forever. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen.
Blessed be the Lord.
For he has heard the voice of my pleas for mercy.
Now and forever.
Old Testament lesson is taken from Genesis chapter 3. Here we hear of the fall into sin, separates us from God. He doesn't walk and talk with us anymore like he used to. But in spite of our sin, our loving God still looks for us. And even here in Genesis 3, he promises a Savior, the offspring of the woman who will crush the devil's head. That, of course, is our Lord Jesus. So Genesis 3. And they heard the sound of the Lord God walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And the man and his wife hid themselves from the presence of the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord God called to the man, and he said to him, "Where are you?" And he said, "I heard the sound of you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, and I hid myself." And he said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten of the tree of which I commanded you not to eat?" And the man said, "The woman you gave to be with me, she gave me fruit of the tree, and I ate." And the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this you have done?" And the woman said, "The serpent deceived me, and I ate." The Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you above all livestock and above all beasts of the field. On your belly you shall go, and dust you shall eat all the days of your life. I will put enmity between you and the woman, and between your offspring and her offspring. You shall bruise your head, and you shall bruise his heel." And this is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Our epistle lesson is from 2 Corinthians chapter 4 and 5. This will be the text for our sermon today. "Since we have the same spirit of faith, according to what has been written, I believe, and so I spoke. But we also believe, and so we also speak. Knowing that he who raised the Lord Jesus will raise us also with Jesus, and bring us with you into his presence. For it is all for your sake, so that his grace extends to more and more people, and may increase thanksgiving to the glory of God. So we do not lose heart, though our outer nature is wasting away, our inner nature has been renewed day by day. For this slight, momentary affliction is preparing for us an eternal weight of glory beyond all comparison, as we look not to the things that are seen, but to the things that are unseen. For the things that are seen are transient, but the things that are unseen are eternal. For we know that the tent, which is our earthly home, is destroyed. We have a building from God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. And this is the word of the Lord."
Thanks be to God.
How about you rise and sing it all over? Seeking you. And he answered them, "Who are my mother and my brothers?" And looking about at those who sat around him, he said, "You here are my mother and my brothers. Whoever does the will of God, he is my brother and sister and mother. And this is the gospel of the Lord. Let's join in confessing our faith in our Lord Jesus, who crushes the serpent's head, who brings us into his kingdom, by confessing the words of the Nicene Creed.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten with his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came out from heaven, and was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us in the righteous Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again according to the Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of the Father.
College years are gone, schooling is over with, and here I am in the real world, shot at the bigs. Statistics show that the average male reaches his physical prime in his early to mid-20s. It's all downhill for me, folks. Aging is a part of life, unfortunately, right? My great-grandmother in her 90s would always warn us as she lay in her convalescent home, don't get old. But we all do, right? And some people handle it better than others, physically and emotionally. But everyone does something to try and cope with it, if not stop it altogether. Billions are spent on anti-aging creams. Billions are spent on exercise equipment and programs and diet research. But try as we might to stave off the effects of age, time doesn't stop. And we get old. And so maybe you buy that fancy car or motorcycle to try and recapture your youth. Others are overcome by lusts and desires and drugs to try and stop the mind-numbing depression and fear that comes when you face the reality of this world that is everything gets old, wastes away, and dies. Paul is not ignorant of this, and so he reminds the people of God, which by the way is you, that there is hope. In the face of this broken world, in the face of the age and the arthritis and the cancer and the death. And that hope isn't in a new car or a new wife or a pill bottle. It's in the new. Paul writes, knowing that he who raised the Lord Jesus will raise us also with Jesus and bring us with you into his presence. See, this world is broken, and it's dying, and it's wasting away. But we are united through baptism, through faith, with the one who has overcome the world, the one who beats death, and the one who is ageless. And his promise is that we will be with him forever. And we know that we keep his promise, because he paid a high price to prove it. God took on flesh and was born in a manger. And then, time went by. And he grew older. And when he turned about my age, just a bit past his physical prime, he started preaching. Preaching about how he was a God of love who came to undo the brokenness of this world that all might have life and light and hope. Yet he was reviled for it. And he was broken and he was beaten. And on his cross, he wasted away. Don't miss the point there. The true God, who is outside of time, who made time, wasted away. Suffered. And he did it so as we grow older, we don't have to be so afraid. Paul writes, so we do not lose heart, though our outer nature is wasting away, our inner nature is being renewed day by day. We are wasting away. We have sins that we can't beat. We have relationship problems. We have pains and fears. We get older, we get slower. And let's face it, folks, we get a little bit crotchier. But do not lose heart. Christ knows what it's like to waste away. He knows what it's like to die. And as we mentioned before, he conquers it. Just as he promised. And that is proof for us that he will keep all his promises that he makes you to. His promise to renew you as you hear his forgiveness proclaimed to you here and in his word. As you receive his body and blood to strengthen and forgive. And as his spirit works to strengthen us with his grace in every time of need. other of our fears, or our depression, or our sin, or our illnesses, or the hardships that afflict us. And you'll notice, I never said any of this wasting away or getting older stuff is fun. Not at all. But the point our lesson makes to us today is that we have hope in it. Hope that one day, all that pain and that sadness and that weakness, that will waste away and it will end. When we go to be with Christ. And even then it gets better. On that last day, in the new creation, when our souls from heaven are back with our bodies and we too rise again, just as Christ is risen. And just like he walked and he talked and he was healed and he was whole, after wasting away on the cross even, we too, after wasting away here in our graves, we will be healed and whole and how we were supposed to be, without the effects of the sin and the age. On that day, well, let's just say our physical crimes will extend a bit past our early 20s, to say the least. So let that be our hope. No matter what age you are, you have good days ahead of you. The days behind you are forgiven. Move on. The present you have now, while we wait here in this broken place, make the most of it. Do what God would have you do. Love your neighbor as yourself in the ways that you are able. Maybe you can't help someone move anymore. You can bring them a meal. Maybe you can't clean someone's gutters, but you can tell them thank you and God bless you when they clean yours. You can share what you've learned in all your days with those who are younger. And when we start slowing down, realize that's the result of being a sinner in a sinful world, and while there's nothing you can really do about it, I mean, diet, medicine, and exercise are certainly blessings that help, but regardless, Christ has already done everything needed. And you have eternal life. So we simply adapt to the new normal. That you need that extra nap. That you need that cane or walker. That you need the reminders. It's okay. Doesn't mean you're less valued. Doesn't mean you're without hope. It means you're going through what everyone else will in this broken world unless the Lord comes back first. And you go through it with hope. Hope and joy that as we go through it, we're not alone. We're not forgotten. We're simply drawing closer to that eternal weight of glory that God has promised us. That will make everything we go through now look like a slight, momentary affliction. Because on that day, when we see our Lord face to face, when we are at the feast in his kingdom, it'll be great. And you know what? I'll see you there. Amen. And now the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in Christ Jesus, our hope, until we meet him and celebrate with him. Amen. Our service continues with the singing of the offertory. You can find it on page 192 of your hymnals.
Thank you.
Please rise as you're able for prayer. Oh, let us pray to the God who binds Satan and plunders the devil's house to grant us salvation. Heavenly Father, we thank you that you have come to rescue us from Satan and to renew this world and our bodies that are wasting away. Give us strength and peace, even as we grow older, to know that we are valued, loved, and we have good days ahead of us for eternity. Lord, in your mercy. God of love, as we live here in the midst of so much hardship, let us be thankful for the blessings you do give us. We thank you for food and drink, house and home, family and friends. Help us to share of what you have given us with those who are in need, even as we recognize you gave your only Son, that we might have what we most need and are most thankful for, forgiveness and life. Lord, in your mercy. For those who are suffering, whether by illness, pain, or sadness, we commend them to you, gracious Lord. Watch over Linda and Walt and Jerry, Pastor Jacob, Joanne, Kale, Norman, Billy, Wendy, and all those we name in our hearts this time. Give them healing and strength now to be your will, but above all, strengthen their faith in their Lord Jesus, that they might rest assured that they have salvation and an eternal victory in Jesus. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
God of power, come through your word to those who sin against the Spirit by unbelief. Raise up smart and faithful Christians, even us, to share your love and truth, that your Spirit might turn their hearts, that they might be forgiven and given a share in your kingdom. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
God of love, may our families reflect your love in acts of forgiveness, sacrifice, and selflessness. Bless our marriages with love and contentment, and give our children safety, discipline, and encouragement. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We thank you that you come to us in bread and wine. May we partake of it in repentance and faith, trusting that in it, which is also your body and blood, you strengthen and forgive us. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy shown in Jesus, the one who saves us from wasting away and gives us eternal life. We pray in his name as he reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our service continues with the service of sacrament found on page 194. Page 194. And the Lord be with you.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on power, and in glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Our Lord Jesus Christ, in the night when he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Just do it in remembrance of me." In the same way also, he took a cup after supper, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to him, saying, "Drink it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. Just do it as often as you drink of it in remembrance of me." And the peace of the Lord be with you all. and fervent love toward one another. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures.